superficial shape and the deep shape. Superficial shape means just deep to the skin in the superficial fossa. That is superficial shape. A deep shape means deep just in front of deep to the muscle. That means in the regarding the arterial system, we know external iliac artery continued as the femoral artery into the inguinal ligament, which was at the lateral compartment of the femoral sheath. It is the continuation of the external iliac artery. And that femoral artery at the level of fifth osteoarthrodic opening, at the fifth osteoarthrodic opening, this is continued as the popliteal artery. Now, this popliteal artery at the level of distal border of popliteus divided into posterior tibial artery and anterior tibial artery. The anterior tibial artery passes above the interosseous membrane in between the tibia and fibula to be continued as the anterior tibial artery. And along the posterior compartment of the leg posterior tibial artery that passes to the sole. In the sole region divided into lateral plantar and medial plantar. Up to this we have already discussed. Now, deep venous system. Deep venous system, it is the venous compartment of the lateral plantar artery and medial plantar artery from the posterior aspect. This is in the lateral plantar artery and medial plantar artery. Then it is continued and this is the posterior tibial artery, anterior tibial artery. Now, venous compartment means when two veins accompanying one artery, one on each side. Clear? These two veins, one on each side of the artery passes, that is known as the vena cavitans, that means accompanying vein. When one artery is accompanied by two veins, one on each side of the artery, suppose this one is the artery, and another one vein and two veins by the side of one artery, one on each side of the artery, that is known as the vena cavitans. So, in the deep artery, that is lateral plantar artery and medial plantar artery, so, vena cavitans of lateral plantar artery and medial plantar artery, these two unite to form the vena cavitans of posterior tibial artery. And similarly, from the dorsum of the foot, from this region, there is dorsal spadis artery. Now, vena cavitans of dorsal spadis artery continue above as the vena cavitans of anterior tibial artery. Because dorsal spadis artery is the continuation of anterior tibial artery from the level of the ankle in between the medial malleolus and lateral malleolus. From this midpoint it is continued as the dorsal spadis artery and it passes to the plantar region in the proximal unit of the vast metatarsal space. Anyway, this vena cavitans of dorsal spadis artery passes upwards as the vena cavitans of anterior tibial artery and at the level of upper margin of the interosseous membrane it passes to posterior compartment above the interosseous membrane and unite with the vena cavitans of the dorsal spadis artery. It also sorry, the posterior tibial artery and unite to form popliteal vein. So popliteal vein is formed at the level of distal border of the popliteus by union of the vena cavitans of posterior tibial artery as well as vena cavitans of anterior tibial artery. In short, we say popliteal vein is formed by union of the anterior tibial vein and posterior tibial vein. Actually, below the level of the knee, actually only not single vein, two vein. That's why it is known as the vena cavitans. Here, so anterior tibial vein and posterior tibial vein unite to form the popliteal vein at the level of the distal border of the popliteus. Now, from this distal border of popliteus, this popliteal vein passes upwards, lies in the floor of the popliteal fossa. At back of the knee, there is popliteal fossa. In the floor of the popliteal fossa, this deep vein, that is popliteal vein, passes upwards. And at the level of deep osteoarthrodic opening, it is the deficiency of the insertion of the adductor magna. There are five openings. Through the fifth opening, femoral artery continued as the popliteal artery. Similarly, popliteal vein enters the thigh, front of the thigh, and the fifth osteoarthrodic opening, and continued as the femoral artery. Clear? Now in the femoral bundle, in the front of the thigh, this continuation of the popliteal artery as the femoral vein from the level of hip osteoarthrodic opening. And that femoral vein passes upward and occupies the middle compartment of the femoral sheath. And through the femoral sheath, it is continued as external iliac vein. And That explanation we are going to unite with the internal element to form the common reaction and common reaction of the right side to unite with the left common reaction at the level of lower border of the right to form the inferior one. That passes upwards along the posterior terminal wall via central diaphragm at the level of the PI vertebra and opens into the right atrium of the heart. And this is about the deep venous system of inferior ischemia. Any query? আরো কোনো কনফিউশন আছে কি বলো? তার কনফিউশন থাকলে বলো, আমি আবার রিপিট করে দিচ্ছি। তার মানে আরো কোনো কনফিউশন থাকলে বলো, বললে আমি আবার বলে দিচ্ছি। আমি এতক্ষণ যেটা বললাম, দিস ইজ দ্য ডিপ ভেনাস সিস্টেম, সি উইচ ইজ জাস্ট লাইক দ্যাট অফ দ্য আর্টারি, বাট আপ টু দ্য বিলো দ্য লেভেল অফ দ্য নি, two veins, one on each side of the artery, that is known as the vena cavitans. So vena cavitans of the lateral medial plantar artery, passing the vena cavitans of posterior tibial artery, unites with the vena cavitans of the central tibial artery, thus forms the popliteal vein, and which passes upwards and enters to the fifth ossear pubic opening and contributes as the femoral vein. This is at the back side. And this femoral vein in the front side of the thigh is femoral vein. Passes upwards of the middle compartment of the femoral seat and enters into the pelvis with the inguinal ligament and contributes the external iliac vein. This external iliac vein unites with the internal iliac vein to form the common iliac vein, which unites the femur of the opposite side at the level of lower border of the L5 vertebra to form the inferior canaliculi, which passes upwards along the posterior abdominal wall to pierce the diaphragm. At the level of PA vertebra, ultimately it opens into the right atrium of the heart. And this is about the deep venous system. Clear? And within the vein, there is infolding of the tibia intima. In each vein, infolding of tibia intima, that forms the valve of the vein. Clear? Achha. Anyway, now, superficial venous system. Superficial venous system starts from the dorsal of the foot. That is, after arterial supply, it becomes capillary, then it becomes vein from the digit. From the digit, that is dorsal digital vein. So, dorsal digital vein in the left toe and the second toe unite at the level of the cleft, the haunch, cleft, from the dorsal metatarsal vein. So, first, second, third, fourth, four dorsal metatarsal vein. It means the 5 to 4 gap, so 4 metatarsal vein, and which is communicated transversely by the dorsal venous arch of the foot. This dorsal venous arch of the foot, it has medial end and the lateral end. Now, vein from the medial side of the dorsal of the foot, that is known as medial marginal vein, and lateral side, that is known as lateral marginal vein. Now, medial end of dorsal venous arch of the foot unite with the medial marginal vein and contribute as the great saphenous vein. So great saphenous vein is formed by union of the medial marginal vein with the medial end of dorsal venous arch of the foot. Now left small saphenous vein, which is formed by union of dorsal venous arch of the foot with the lateral marginal vein. This is known as the small saphenous vein or short saphenous vein. Clear? Now, in front of the medial malleolus, this great saphenous vein passes upwards in front of the leg, then passes backward behind the medial side of the knee and occupies the front of the thigh, and it passes upwards and which pierces the right from fossa. And there is deficiency, overall deficiency of the fossa latae or deep fossa of the thigh, that is known as the saphenous opening. And in this opening there is seam like chakri, makosa jale moto, thin layer of connective tissue fiber, that is known as the tribiform fossa. Tribiform means seam like fossa, seam means chakri, erum dharma ka fossa. Okay, this fossa is known as the tribiform fossa, and this fossa is pierced by the great saphenous vein and which opens into the femoral vein. And before opening, piercing the calcium fossa, it receives the veins, that is superficial circumference iliac vein, superficial epigastric vein, and superficial external pudendal vein. From genitalia, the vein is known as the external pudendal vein. From lower abdomen, superficial epigastric vein. And from post endosuperior vein, that is superficial circumflex iliac vein. These three vein opens into the dead saphenous vein before piercing the ribosome muscle to open into the pleural vein. Now another vein, anterior femoral pleural vein, medial pleural pleural vein, and other tubules in the leg that opens into the dead saphenous vein. Now in this vein, 20 number of imprinting of the tibia intima, that is valve. You see, then venous valve, which allow the valve to pass upwards. Venous vein, this one is the vein imprinting of the tibia intima, imprinting of tibia intima, and that is known as the venous valve. And blood will pass above upwards because against gravity. When blood passes above and it will not allow to back to the vein. Here, in such way, by contraction of the calf muscle, okay, by contraction of the calf muscle, that will squeeze the calf muscle and blood will pass upwards, and if at this level it pass upwards, it will not pass downwards, due to presence of the valve. Here, this is about the great saphenous vein. Now, small saphenous vein, which is formed by the union of lateral end of the dorsal venous arch of the foot after union with the lateral marginal vein, which passes backwards along the lateral border of the foot below the lateral malleolus till it passes upwards in between the lateral malleolus and the pendocalcaneum, back of the leg, pendocalcaneum. Then this vein passes upwards along the back of the leg and at the level of popliteal fossa, it opens into the popliteal vein. So this is about the small saphenous vein. This is about the small saphenous vein. Small saphenous vein. This is the great saphenous vein. Great or long saphenous vein. Now the flow chart, that is deep venous system we have already discussed. That is vena comitant of the dorsal femoral artery from anterior aspect and vena comitant of the lateral medial plantar artery. Lateral medial plantar continues to form the vena comitant of posterior tibial artery or vena comitant of anterior tibial artery, continuation of vena comitant of dorsal femoral artery. These two vena comitants from anterior aspect and from posterior aspect unite to form the popliteal vein. So this popliteal vein passes through the fifth osteopulmic opening and continues the femoral vein. Now, this is about the deep venous system. Now, the superficial venous system. Superficial venous system, this one. That is, dorsal venous, superficial venous system of the dorsal digital vein. This one is the dorsal digital vein. Dorsal metatarsal vein. Dorsal venous arch of the foot. Now, the dorsal venous arch of the foot. From lateral end, unite with the lateral marginal vein. From the small saphenous vein, opens into the popliteal vein. Now, medial end of the dorsal venous arch of the foot, from medial end, great saphenous vein, after union with the medial marginal vein, that great saphenous vein opens into the femoral vein. Here, this is about the superficial venous system and deep venous system. So, inferior extremity is joined by two sets of vein. One is the superficial venous set and the deep venous set. Deep venous set corresponding to the arterial disposition, and a vein accompanying the artery, there is deep structure, more deeper, or superficial venous system like deep to the skin in the superficial fossa. That is what is visualized in the inner leg, even from superficial. And deep vein we cannot observe or see, but cannot follow. Only superficial, this one is the superficial. Here, now follow that. The dorsal venous arch of the foot. The dorsal digital vein. It is medial end of dorsal great saphenous vein. Is it bent? Great saphenous vein. Medial marginal vein. Great saphenous vein. Is it bent? Great saphenous vein. Are you thinking low? Small saphenous vein. Back of the leg is small saphenous vein. At front of the leg, great seven has been front of the thigh, great seven has been. Now, in the great seven has been, in 20 to 22, 25, when a half present in the great seven has been. And in the back of the leg, there is small seven has been, 8 to 12 half. Clear? In case of peripheral heart of the body, peripheral heart region, that is calf muscle. Calf muscle by contraction again, by movements. By contraction of the calf muscle, popliteal vein is squeezed and blood will pass upwards. Because you squeeze it, venous blood in the popliteal vein that is collected from periphery, that will be pumped out to the pleural vein, then passes to inferior vein. In such way, the blood passes upwards. That's why calf muscle, we squeeze the popliteal vein. Calf muscle is known as peripheral heart acts as the pump. The calf muscle acts as the pump to push blood from the lower extremity to the upper the heart. That's why calf muscle here, especially calf muscle, especially soleus, is known as the peripheral heart. And now the clinical importance. Now the person, for due to long standing, one of the cardiac, particularly tram driver, train driver, or salesman in the garment shop, from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. or 10 p.m. Continuously standing. As a result of which there is no contraction of the calf muscle. So blood column in the popliteal vein that gives pressure, back pressure, over the small sphenoid vein. As a result of which you continuous prolonged standing for long days, that will damage the heart. The venous valve will be damaged, the valve will be loose. As a result of which, blood flow will back, to the superficial vein. And congestion, collection of the blood, distension and short process. That is known as varicose vein. Varicose vein. Clear? That is known as varicose vein. If great seven has been involved, in that case, in front of the medial malleolus and front of the leg, there will be tortuosity. And if there is involvement of the small seven has been, tortuosity in the back of the leg. So, if there is tortuosity, worm-like structure, in the skin, that is known as, it is happen of varicose in the small seven has been. Are it is in front of the medial malleolus, great saphena, saphena valley to the great saphena. Up to this clear, this is about the venous system of lower extremity.